I woke up like this. I woke up like this. We flawless. Welcome, everyone, to the SMITE Art Show with your guests. That guy. Actually, no, hosts. Excuse me. I'm Hyra Zena, and that's Hyra's Gavin,
unfortunately.
A.K.A. the worst, A.K.A. baby hands, A.K.A. stupid haircut, A.K.A. gray on gray, really. So, welcome, everyone. If you guys are new to the show, this is a show where we showcase artwork. How many times can I say show in a sentence?
As many as you possibly can.
Show. So yeah, guys, welcome to the show. We're going to be going over some really cool artwork. And yeah, Gavin, you want to give us a little recap?
Yeah, so I fought Andy so we could have you back from the showcase.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I was on showcase last week. So that was really fun.
We got her back, guys. I know. I'm
thank
sorry.
God. No. Really, you did not have to fight. Thank God.
All right, everyone. Awful. So if you weren't here last week, we had a great time. Actually, it was our first show back from our little break we took.
Yeah, in the fancy new space.
Yeah, and we are in the fancy new space.
Yep.
Looks like I've got Mercury over my shoulders again.
Yeah.
So I'm just...
It's right there.
Last week we went over, like, that was mostly fan art last week. We had about, what, 98 submissions that we went through. It was pretty crazy. Yeah. It was
build up from 3 weeks of not having
and we
the
had
art
some,
show.
We had some really great stuff, and we had that shape challenge from last, I guess it was like 3 weeks ago now.
Yeah.
But yeah, you set that out. We had some really, really cool stuff with that. We have some really cool stuff this week as well.
Yep.
But on the subject of challenges... We did a holiday challenge, I believe.
We did. Just overall encompassing all holiday things,
yeah,
obviously
we wanted,
near Christmas.
We wanted to show, like, togetherness and stuff. So kind of like the gods in their families.
Exactly.
Because, you know, we have, like, the pantheons, like Zeus and his, like, a trillion kids that he has.
Zeus.
Yeah. So
you're crazy.
But, yeah. So we want to see that kind of like, so theme it with togetherness,
yeah,
the holidays, or not the holidays, but togetherness in general, yeah, that happy feeling of hooray.
And it doesn't necessarily have to be the gods and their direct relations with the other Mayan gods of the same pantheon. It could be just a whole array of different gods that you just want to see all together. So really, it's just no set guidelines. Just make it holiday-themed, obviously SMITE-themed, and go crazy with it. And obviously, it's going to go into the next week, too. So you will not be receiving a new challenge this week.
Yeah, just continue on with that.
Till the new year, I guess?
Yeah. Holidays. Yeah, we want to keep it holiday-y. We may actually add more stuff to the challenge, like more specifics as it draws closer to a specific holiday.
Yeah.
Or if we just have a crazy idea that we want to throw your way, we'll throw your way.
Yeah, so we're okay with the fact that this time for this show, we don't have that many submissions because we're just going to peg it to be that everybody else is working so hard on getting their crazy awesome submission, and that's why. Okay.
Yeah,
but doesn't matter. Regardless, we still have some amazing stuff to show you guys. There's a piece that, like, I'm so excited to show you. So, and also, I will be drawing on the show.
A Willix. But, so you just saw Willix on the patch note, or I guess not patch notes, dev talk.
Dev talk
patch
yeah.
notes is until tomorrow. But let's see how Enna draws Willix.
And guys, oh my God, can you imagine? I actually, like, finished a drawing, kind of. Or I'm going to try. I'm aiming to finish a drawing on the show.
Nah, it's not going to happen.
Something's
going to happen, Gavin, that's going to prevent you from successfully.
Yeah, I'm going to have to beat you up. That's what's going to happen.
Yeah, that'll be it.
That's definitely it. Oh, he looks kind of like a koala bear. So right now what I'm doing, guys, I already went ahead and I drew a Willix, her body. It was really interesting drawing her from the side because obviously you don't get a lot of the side action. But it's nice to draw her from the side. And I'm drawing her little leopard companion or jaguar companion. Mm. What's her name?
I've already forgotten.
Yeah, I forgot the name. Chat, what was the name of the... Suku? Chat, help me. Help me, Jack.
They just saw Dev Talk. I think they're going to be just as in the dark as we are.
Oh, yeah.
I'm bad with names.
Me too.
I was surprised I got a Willix.
A Willix. So our very own Dave, I love him. He's awesome. He's one of the 2D artists. He came up with a hilarious thing that we should do. It should be one of the voice packs. But you know that Iggy Azalea song?
Mm-hmm.
It should be like, first things first, I'm a Willix. Oh my God, Gavin, come down from there. Can we get the blood splats in the back like we did during the showcase? Please, I feel
guys.
Production, get those blood splats up. Okay, fine.
Oh man, Man,
that'd be funny though.
I miss this art show, guys.
You're the worst. But yeah, guys, we're gonna keep the artwork going in the background while we
while she tries to talk with you and sketch at the same time.
I know.
Spoiler: it won't work.
I might end up drawing my words because I'm trying so hard to do two things at once. Have you ever done that when you're talking to someone on the phone and you're writing something and you end up writing?
Oh yeah,
you're just saying,
like, you're just writing out your phone conversation.
Buts.
Or you just start reading off what you were supposed to be writing.
Oh yeah.
So you're like, yeah. So one time I went to this party and then all of a sudden.
Eggs. Milk.
Bread. Yeah.
Anna, what's wrong with you? Yeah. I know that all too well. So,
okay, I don't want to cover anything up, so I'm kind of like leaning.
Oh, wait, no. There that is. But yeah, guys, I'm going to be done with the grayscale in a minute. I'm going to hide it. See? To reveal.
So do you generally start off with a rough grayscale?
Yes.
When you do your art?
I do. Actually, I can show you guys the super rough one that I did. I can, like, do this. And then, oh, no, that was the other one that I was doing that I wasn't very happy with. Oh, well, I guess I erased it.
Wow, Anna.
Oh, no. Oh, wait, no, I didn't erase it. I just went ahead and, like, I've been doing this thing where I don't draw on top of the grayscale. I just go ahead and turn it dark to dark lines, turn it completely black.
So you, like, clean it
up. Yeah, and then I just clean it up. That's what I do.
For aspiring artists, what would you recommend? Doing grayscale first and then darkening it up? Or do you
absolutely. Grayscale first, for sure. Or, like, maybe light blue or something, like traditional artists do. Sometimes they use that blue colored pencil.
Oh, it looks so good,
too. It looks really good. And also, something about the light color of the brush strokes makes it a little less intimidating. Obviously, if you take a black brush stroke, it's a lot more intense. So if you take, a light one, you feel a little bit more comfortable being more dangerous with your lines or going crazy.
Right.
You know what I mean? So. Oh, he's so cute. Or wait, is it a she? It's a she, isn't it?
I don't know.
God, Gavin.
I know. I'm so bad at this. I'm
fired.
Sorry. Yeah.
Good. It's okay. I don't know either. But I swear, I thought it was a girl. Yeah, Suku. Yeah. Yeah, but that's a girl's name, all right. I love you, production. You're the best. Okay, bye. Yeah. All right, now I'm going to start coloring. But hold on, I want to give that effect.
Yeah, I'm looking through. If you guys have any questions about any of this stuff that Anna's doing, or specifics on how to improve or anything like that, just throw it our way.
Man, I wish we were doing Ask Gavin.
Make Gavin do a drawing next show.
Yes!
No.
Guys, how would you feel if we got Kelly in here instead of me and we did like the little switch around because I did Smite Showcase with Andy, get Kelly in here and do the
Kelly
art show with Gavin?
That would be...
What do you guys think of that?
Terrible.
I think it'd be hysterical. Be quite funny. Oh, jeez.
As long as Kelly's drawing. Like, that's the most important part for me. I want her to actually be drawing.
Oh, God. I can't. What? Okay.
So, alternatively to doing a kind of, like, rough gray line work or blue line work,
mm-hmm.
If you remember, Kayla was always a fan of doing doing rough shapes in large gray blobs.
Kayla would just go right in. She would dive in with color. She would establish the grayscale first of what she wanted the drawing to be. She would establish the shadows and everything like that. She would just dive right into it, and then she would draw around it.
Right.
And then she would add color with an overlay, I think. So
yep.
I just have more of a, like, flat black line, and then I color underneath it.
Right.
But I've been doing a lot of, like, crazy other stuff, too. I've been experimenting.
Experimenting.
So.
With
but
your
for
style.
Now. For now, I'll stick with this one because I'm very happy with it. So, oh my god, these swatches are so awful. Oh no. There we go. Alright, I'm going to get a moderately reddish skin tone. How the Mayan people always had like some sort of mud paint on their bodies.
Mud
kind
paint?
Of. Well, I don't know. They just had like generally more reddish skin. So I'm going to do... Definitely don't want too orangey. This one's perfect.
So we use, for the art show and mostly for, and also for her kind of like 2D art that she does for the God reveals and anything else she does, it's mostly Photoshop.
Yes.
And that's what we're currently using right now.
Yes. Photoshop. with an Intuos tablet. Which, guys, tablets are awesome for beginners. We've always had that question, so that's why I'm going to go ahead and say that. If you're wondering what's best for a beginner, go to Best Buy or Amazon and buy the bamboo tablets.
They're not bamboo anymore. They're just Intuos. There's a difference between Intuos and Intuos Pro. The Pro ones are more expensive. Intuos ones are the more affordable, smaller, and really great for beginners.
The ones that are just like tablets that don't have any kind of...
screen and
have a screen or any kind of like fancy capabilities. They're just you draw on it and that's it. Even the Pen and Touch one is really good too. But
Kayla does
like
bring
it.
Up a good point. MS Paint is another option.
We get
a lot of MS Paint art, and
we
there's
have some of
really
favorites.
We've got some really good stuff in, like not just the goofy stuff we get because we get a lot of goofy stuff that we love. But there's also like there's people who really get into their MS Paint work, and you can tell. Like granted. It still looks like MS Paint, but you can tell there's time put into them, and they look, they have a very distinct look to them.
And actually, one of our challenges in the past has been best MS Paint.
Oh, yeah.
So.
That was, we got.
We get a kick out of
that. You know what we have to do?
What do we have to do?
We have to do best of 2015.
Yes, we do.
Or 2014, sorry. Going into, oh, man. Guys.
We got to do that.
This is exciting, because.
Oh, my God.
Anna, you ruin everything.
Yep.
Everything.
My goal in life.
But yeah, we did last year going into 2014 for 2013. We did a best of and did categories and we gave away gem prizing.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll probably do that again.
Well, I
coming up
I
soon,
hope
folks.
So.
Probably like, oh man, holidays.
It's gonna be like in a
right
couple
around
weeks.
The bend. Yeah. Oh man, guys.
In a couple weeks.
It's happening. Well, I'll get all that stuff and I'll post that on our Twitter to let you know what the categories are, and I'll probably have you vote some too because. Your opinion matters.
Huh. Don't listen then. All right, I don't have a concept of a Willix right now, so I'm just kind of going with how I, from memory, all of her color and everything, because I did do her lore, so I'm going to... God, I know this part's gold, and this part's green.
Hey, production, can we see more of the art and less of me?
No, more of Gavin. Do a straight shot of Gavin.
No, don't.
We can't.
Whatever you do, don't do that. Whatever you do.
I'll just draw Gavin in
don't,
the back.
Don't do that.
Why not? It's going to be so much fun. Yeah, there we go. Guys, can I just point out this hand? I'm so happy with it.
She's freaking out.
I'm so happy with this hand. That's so nice. All right. Anyway, back to the drawing.
So hands are always something that give people problems.
Yes, so much. That's why I get really pumped when I actually manage to draw a hand properly, or at least enough for me to not cringe when I see it.
Mm-hmm. So. Do you have any like special tricks for drawing hands? Do you just do a lot of practice? Have you done?
Most of the time, it's just luck, honestly.
Luck.
Yeah, really, it is. Like this hand right here, I drew like maybe three different variations of this hand and what it would be doing. And I just was like, you know what, I'm going to do something different. And I changed it around and I got that one. So, but a good tool or a good way of learning how to draw hands is the way I do it. If you want to like be rough with it, you just draw a little shape like that. You just make it very, actually, no, hold on. Scratch that. I got a better idea. You do like this little shape, right? And then... five, and then a thumb. And then you go ahead and you clean it up afterwards.
Oh, look at that.
Obviously,
the
fingers, if you look at your fingers, you have spaces, so they can't be super close together. Even when they are together, you still have a little bit of space. And always remember that, ooh, voice cracked. Always remember the height differences between the fingers. So obviously the middle one is a lot taller than the index, but the one over here... the ring finger is a little bit taller than the index, though. So, does that make sense? Does that make
look
sense?
At that.
Yeah, just.
Quick hands done right.
Yep, and then that part, and that.
Yeah, is that the technical term? That part.
That part.
That part.
That part.
That hand part. There we go. Yeah, don't ever forget that part, guys.
Don't forget that part,
don't
guys.
Don't ever forget it.
But yeah, that's a quick way of doing it. But if you're not doing a high five directly on drawing, Probably what's the best thing you could do is just go online, and especially on DeviantArt. Yeah, and just look up hand poses. There are so many, because so many artists have this problem where they can't, you know, get dynamic poses with their hands. So either buy a little statuette that has like all the hand joints together, or you just go online and you check it out. That's all you gotta do. Right, Gavin?
Exactly.
Shut up.
Yeah, that's, there's really nothing I could have said that would have gotten. Yeah.
No, you're just the worst, aren't you? Yep. Sitting there. Aren't ya? Just watching.
Yeah, don't ever feel bad about using reference. Like, just make sure if you, like, are taking that whole pose or if you're recreating that entirely, to give credit to the original artist.
Of course. Yeah. Whee!
All right, guys, so we're going to get into some fan art so Anna can focus on this because she's...
I'm going to finish this.
She's going to finish it. She promises.
I'm going to.
So we're going to get right into this community fan art so you guys can see all the wonderful art you've done over the last week.
Oh, my God. Community farts with Anna and Gap.
All right, so our first piece by Alex. You know, this feels wrong.
Camarena?
Yeah, I just want you to do all the names. You don't even... Just look up enough long enough to
I'll
do the name.
I'll do this name because it has my name at the end. And this one's by Alex Camarena, and it's Hell. But this is very interesting. Instead of the body of Hell, we get the hands. Kind of like a
we
creation
got this
of David.
We got some... Plus, there's that like nice little swirl going on in the middle.
Yeah, I like it. I think it's colored pencil. It looks colored pencil.
Definitely looks like colored pencil. Mm-hmm. It's a really cool concept. You got Hell's hands pretty down.
I like it.
We were just talking about hands and how difficult they are.
I know.
It's like we planned this,
God,
guys.
Right?
We super, super didn't.
Kill him.
Super not ready for anything. And this the glorious Artie. I believe this is supposed to be a Scylla skin.
Just like octopus.
It's just like this crazy octopus Scylla.
It's kind of creepy.
It is actually
very
exceptionally creepy.
Very.
I like the alt form in the back.
Yeah.
Goes up and it's just like this roid raged octopus.
My favorite part of this is the little cute belly button that he's rocking.
Yeah, yeah.
The main one. It's just so cute.
It's even. I feel like there's a name on that I can't read.
Right.
But yeah, there's a lot of.
Uko.
Yeah, there's some interesting stuff.
RDM's so funny. Oh, I love this. Oh, by the way, thank you for being so liberal in your personality giving for my character. I appreciate that, Artie. You're my favorite person ever. But yeah, this is when we were, I was on the showcase with Andy, and I don't know which Andy you're looking at, but he is more buff than that. You need to get your life together.
Yeah, like... There's neck bulges coming up when you look at him, just like muscles on top of muscles.
Muscles on muscles on muscles.
Yeah. In fact, most of the time when you're talking to him, he's doing that pec bounce thing.
It's really distracting.
Like,
I can't talk to him.
I get it, man. Just like stop flashing those pecs.
Yep.
It's a little much for me.
He doesn't even drive a car. He just runs home.
He runs home.
He's amazing. Hate that guy. So, RDM, thank you so much for that. We always love your style.
Bringing the showcase and the art show together.
This one. I love this one. Oh, my God. Kronos never looked so fancy.
Oh,
ever. This is obviously Thanatos. And his cup of souls. But it's so light. It's so nice and
cup
and cute.
Of souls. He's just like, I feel like this is how he wakes up in the morning.
I woke up like this.
Not again.
I woke up like this.
He just sits there and he's just like,
soulless.
gonna have to reap some gods today.
Oh my God. It's Art Show Beyonce edition.
Oh my goodness.
Actually, that was really funny. I woke up like this, soulless, instead of flawless. That's funny. Gavin, quit hitting yourself. It's funny. But I love it. It's nice. It looks like a pen, possibly. Pen doodle on paper.
Yeah.
Very well done. And very cute, too. Very funny. Oh, yes. You guys obviously know one of my favorite games is
Five
Nights
at Freddy's. What,
are
you going to call me out?
What? Oh, yeah. He's coming for you, Gavin, because he wouldn't possibly come for me because I'm too sweet.
How much did you freak out when you were playing through that game?
So Oh my God, it was insane. And the thing is, though, I did it to myself. I made sure all the lights were off, the door was locked, and my dog was in his crate, and I was just like, all right, let's do this. And I think I peed a little. Just now, not when I was playing the game. No, but I love this. I would love to see. Actually, we had a spin-off. An artist did a Five Nights at Freddy's crossover with Smite.
Yeah, it was like Five Nights at Smite or
Yeah,
something like
I
that.
would love to see more of that, guys.
But yeah, great job, Damien Dakota.
I love it. Yeah, you did a really good job with the texture too of the video going out.
This next piece by David Lopez. It's a little comic book piece.
It's cute. It's a Fenrir
I
coming
love
in.
the looks that they the Scylla, I guess that's Zoe and Fenrir are
Yeah.
exchanging. They're just like,
I like it. It's got such good personality, and it's a little blurry, so guys, just keep in mind when you're giving us pieces that you're taking a picture of it, make sure it comes out as nice as
Yeah, it looks like it's
possible.
being held up. You don't need to hold it
Yeah.
up. Just put it down somewhere.
And if you don't have
Take
a
your
good
camera.
camera, just
Boom.
like go to Kinko's and they'll scan it in for like $2 or something.
Yeah, but
It's
who
not
wants to
even
spend $2?
right.
Then there's the gas money. Yeah, and come
Yep.
on.
Maybe
Come
you pass by Chipotle and you get super hungry, and then it's like $5.
Yeah. Damn.
Ugh, I
That's
want
the
Chipotle.
worst. All
This
right,
next
this
one.
is by Eric Vasbo.
Oh, I miss Al Kuang too. I miss Noodle. But I don't know. I really like the new design for Al Kuang. He looks sexy. He is so fine.
He is. I mean,
Good
honestly,
boy.
once you ult, you turn back into a giant noodle.
That's
It's
true.
like one big udon noodle.
Yum, I'm hungry.
Yep, I am actually very hungry.
Yeah.
You immediately said Chipotle, and my gut instinct was
Chipotle?
to be hungry.
Chipotle?
Chipotle.
It's Chipotle's sister chain, Chipotle.
Chipotle.
All right, this next one. More hell. Everybody loves
We have
hell.
all this
Jesus.
like yeah we have been getting a ridiculous amount of hell
So
recently,
much hell.
but this is some cool stuff going on with the light energy and dark energy. I don't
Yeah.
know if she's between her like in her little underworld between hell and I think Valhalla,
Oh.
but
That's funny, because her name's hell.
it's so funny because we get a lot of old hell's visual style
Yeah.
mixed with the new look of hell. I like it.
I like it too. I almost wish that the overall god in the game was like that, just half and half. But each outfit has its own things going on, so I can imagine they wouldn't want to do that. It might
This
be
is
too
like a this
loud.
is like Two-Face from Batman Hell.
Yeah. I love it, guys. Good job. And also excellent job on the energy around them too. You can see every single brush stroke, and it's really nice. And it's a lot better sometimes to show the brush stroke. Keep it messy.
But great job, Erikos.
Yeah, good job.
This one is by Felipe Robinson, and it's a Lubu skin for Guan Yu.
Yeah.
I'm a huge fan,
Yeah.
being like a huge Dynasty Warriors player. Love me some Lubu, and some Guan Yu. So
Shout out to
seeing
Chef
Lubu,
Lubu.
yeah, seriously.
Shout out if you're on chat. Is he in chat?
I don't know.
Aw.
Oh no, it's Lubu.
No, Lubu. But yeah, I love this.
It would work. It
Yeah,
would
and
work.
guys, always like we're always open with God concepts and everything like that, just as long as you make it known which God you want a concept
I
of.
actually love the name for the skin, Raging Demon on Battlefield Demon. Like that's
Department of Redundancy
yeah,
Department.
that's just ready.
That's
Like
so
that's
good.
so right.
It's ready to go. But excellent job.
I like how he spelled his name correctly and then we misspelled it because we're really good at this.
We? That would
That's
be
me.
you,
That was
sir.
super me.
That would be you. All right.
We have a Kukulkan by Gerard Pescozo. This is pretty cool. He looks fierce.
Oh my God, he does.
He's just like coming out at you like I'm gonna bite your face off. We got
Funny.
pen or sorry, pencil on paper.
Yeah.
Right in a it looks like you've got a legitimate drawing notebook. That is great.
Yeah, right? Most of the time we get like actual like school notebooks,
Yeah,
which is
school
fine
pads and
too,
all
because
that.
school needs that. But no,
It's
this
just
is
doodle
great.
time, really.
Yeah. If you have any colored pencils or anything like that, please, we would love to see it colored.
And
Guys, there's
Kukulkan's
no.
such a good opportunity
Yeah.
to color in. There's so many, like he's got such a cool palette of color, especially in those
Yeah.
wings. Oh man.
Oh God,
Like
those
his
wings.
gold skin, those like
Oh.
white black shining wings.
Oh.
Badass.
Yeah, it looks great. So we would love to see this colored. And then by the same artist, we have Kronos coming in.
Same notebook, possibly the next page.
Oh
But
my
I
God.
like how he kind of used the side of his pencil, or maybe that's just shadow. But no, that's definitely intentional. He's got
Is it?
the swing of his scythe kind of like
Yeah, I see it.
along it. I love that. That's just adds a lot of character to the piece. It looks really, really great. Also, like the roughness of the wings. It just kind of gives it this whole like he's still in motion kind of look to it. Like he's up there, just like I'm gonna get your soul.
Yeah, is that what he's?
Yeah, that's what he says all the time. Everyone knows that.
Oh my god, whoever was on this monitor.
Everyone that plays Kronos knows that.
It's so dusty. Oh yay, Ian Emsons. Actually, our dearest Kayla, actually helped him a lot with this design because he submitted an older one. But he thought it had some issues and everything like that, so he asked for advice, and Kayla so graciously gave him really good advice, and this is the end result. So good job, Ian, as always. I mean, you always do such a good job, but also good job, Kayla, for giving him really good advice.
Wow. I actually trolled chat with the Thanatos thing.
What do you mean?
Yeah!
What'd you do?
I called Thanatos Kronos. I'm having an identity crisis. I almost said Kronos, and then
you need to calm down.
There's so many. I don't even know.
Wait, is chat still confused?
They're new here because they're from Dev Talk. So
oh, hey, welcome. That's a thing.
But
yeah, seriously.
I was just letting them know. I'm just letting them know.
Thank you, production. Goodness.
All right, so we have Itzander Vroom. If that's your real last name, that's the best. Look at this. This is what we were talking about. We got family time.
Yeah, it's perfect.
And what looks like on top of a Mount Olympus. And aww. Tusky's eating all the salad. That pig.
Okay, so wait. Apollo and Artemis brother and sister, but they're the children of Zeus, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
One of many sets of children that he's had.
Athena's not, though. Is she? I thought she was.
I feel like... I don't remember. I feel like Poseidon might be involved in there, but I think I'm thinking of Venus actually instead of Aphrodite.
Either way, I love this. I love that how you made it on top of Mount Olympus. You made the ground into clouds, but it still has earthy things coming out of it, like little grass and trees. I love this. This is gorgeous. And the little cloud with the fountain on top.
And yeah, there's a lot of color. I love the color pencil
usage.
So
much detail. Oh, my gosh.
We don't get that many colored pencil.
Well, yeah, we don't.
We get some every now and then, but I'd like to see more. I love color pencil.
Yeah.
It's like throwback to me doodling as a kid.
Oh, yeah, is it?
You know what? You know what? John's the S with this...
I love this one.
This snake-inspired... or snake-charmer-inspired Scylla.
I love it, too.
I feel like that would work, too.
We've gotten a few submissions in the past where people have done concepts for Scylla and they've used snakes instead of dogs, excuse me. So I like that.
I like the little note, the dress is a basket.
I would love to do like an underwater Scylla. Like, I mean, she's obviously water as well. She resides in water, but I'm saying like deep ocean water and have her
dogs. Oh, like that
dogs
creepy,
be.
Like, you remember that skin we got a long time ago? That like
yeah, the creepy one.
Yeah, that one was awesome.
I want, instead of the dogs, do eels. Like moray
ooh,
eels.
Yeah.
That'd be really cool.
But this is also like really, I'm liking it. Snakes. I think that would look really fun. Just having that sticking out when she's using her three. Just like snake pops out of the ground.
Yeah.
I have a feeling a lot of people would just freak out.
That would be really cool. Yay! And this is what we're talking about, guys, with MS Paint. This might be MS Paint. This might be Photoshop. Looks like MS Paint, but it's adorable. It's Athena, obviously.
I'm going to say Jordy Wolfcole with Athena. Looking, like, super pumped.
She's so ready.
Like, she is ready. I think that's actually what she does right before she ults. Instead of the crouching down, she's just like, I'm ready! And then she just leaps.
That's the happiest I've ever seen Athena. She's always so stern.
Yeah.
So stern. Good job. I love it. I don't know if that's
This is assaulting my eyes with that background thing. Good. Congratulations. My
Can
eyes.
Can you find a sailboat? Remember those things?
Oh, yeah.
They were awful.
They were awful. Like this, I can't look away. Yeah. Fenrir is adorable.
Oh, it's not Fenrir. Wait, is it? Yeah, it's Fenrir.
Yeah, it's like little baby Fenrir.
Oh, that's right. I don't know if this is the artist or if it's Kelly or I don't know who's that.
A preschool teacher, just randomly.
Just random. But yeah, she got her hand.
I love the little blood just ring around his face while he's like, yum.
I love the tip of the hat to his lore because, as you guys know, him and Tyr, Fenrir helped himself to Tyr's
See, they should have seen it coming, really.
They really should
have. He's all about biting off those arms.
Yeah, but this is before he grew up, so.
Speaking of Fenrir, we have another piece by Justin McClanahan.
He's so good at these.
I love it.
What
Using
it, like,
the negative space and just like Oh, you can even see the hairs of Fenrir. Oh, this is just so good. Such a good time.
That's
looking
really
at these.
Good. My favorite one is the Aphrodite he did.
Oh, yeah.
Because he did it from the old card, which was my favorite.
Yeah, we got into this pretty hard last week.
Yeah, that's right. So I'm not going to say anything else. You know that card's the best. Damn you.
Oh, we have another submission by Kiwifish. It's been a long time.
It has. We missed you, Kiwifish.
And it looks like this piece is traditional, which is not something we always... That's not something we usually get from... I was going to say traditionally get, and then I stopped myself.
No, we have gotten traditional stuff from her, but just more brightly colored and...
That's true.
Not so, I guess, like, liney, if that's even...
So this looks like marker and pen.
Yeah, it looks like... It definitely looks like marker, that background, for sure.
But I like what that makes the night sky look interesting.
Yeah. It's very well done, Kiwifish. Killing
it.
I love these two. This is Freya, and the Holiday Fenrir is actually his skin from last year, where he's got the Rudolph nose and everything.
He's got that scarf.
He's got the ugly holiday sweater. Oh, that would be actually fantastic for another challenge, or a challenge add-on, if you will. Draw gods in the ugliest sweaters, or design your favorite Smite ugly sweater. I think
actually,
that would be really cool.
If someone actually knits those sweaters, if we could get a Smite ugly sweater, I will wear it at the company holiday party.
We don't have to, like, you guys can knit them if you want.
Just saying,
but
if you do that, I will wear that at the company party.
Yeah. All right, guys, so that's it.
And you guys can... We'll take pictures.
Gavin will wear an ugly holiday sweater
if you knit one. With love.
With love, of course. With disdain, even. He'll still wear it.
Another, is this, yeah, same artist, Lauren Feezy Edwards. This is on her.
On her?
It looks like there's a lot of things written underneath on her that have been scratched out. But oh well.
What, were you trying to figure out the name? On her, Dennis.
Can suck.
Michael.
Yeah, all right, well.
Richard.
I see that now.
I would love for us to, like, create a god with the most simple name.
Yeah.
Like Arnold.
Greg.
Arnold the Destroyer.
Greg the God.
Greg the God. He is.
After this one by Milana Kulik, we should check out what Anna's currently working on, because she's got some color in there, and it's starting to look fine.
Aw, thanks, Gavin.
But this piece, it looks like a more lighthearted version of Nox, where she's like a wedding gown.
She's getting married.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That is really cool. I like that skin a lot.
The shading, this is colored pencil, I believe, as well, and the shading is really great. And the fact that you, like, the lace cape that she's wearing.
Yeah.
You did that all by hand, and you got the transparency showing with the little flaming heart in the background.
That's actually one of my favorite effects to do, guys. Just a little pointer from Milan. And also, when you're doing lace, something like that, where it's see-through, you don't necessarily have to go and draw a design in the lace. And if you can see closely, it's legit pen scribbles. You do that, and you do it nicely and cleanly and light, it comes out looking like lace. I mean, look at it. It's a perfect example of it right here. So don't ever kill yourself over drawing when you know there might be, like, a more easy way about it. So.
All right, so we're going to switch back to Anna right now, and we're going to see what she's up to.
I already did.
Look at that.
The basic coloring. I'm doing this one over here.
So what are you going to do with the... Are you going to go crazy with the feathers?
Maybe.
Or are you just going to be going, try to finish it?
All right, listen, I'm just trying to finish this. I'm trying
this
will so
be like what your
this.
Second piece ever finished during the art show.
No,
if
I've
you
never
finish
finished.
No, I feel like you. No, wait, you're right. No, you're right. You're
yeah, I've
right.
never finished a drawing.
When we showed off Cirquette for the first time, because remember we
yeah,
revealed
I
who Cirquette was in one of our art show pieces.
That's right.
Right before Dev Talk, you finished her line work.
I did, which I feel like it's good enough. Chat, I think it's good enough. Love me, chat. I'm sorry.
Please.
I feel like at this point, chats, like, people are starting to wonder. They're like, wait a minute, does she even draw? Like, do you have somebody that draws all those pieces that you post?
We're gonna
on Facebook.
Switch back to our fan art right now. And we got Reagan Gibran.
Reagan Gibran.
This looks like Neith. And Cirquette. That threw me off real hard for a second.
Oh, it's
I was
a combo.
Like, I was like, what's going on here? Are they trying to get me with the Thanatos
like
Kronos thing?
I think that was a challenge we gave one time where you should do a crossover of two of your favorite gods.
God mix and match.
Yeah, God mix and match. I like this. I like this a lot.
Someone from chat points out that, did you finish the Nox one, or did you just fake it by having it already done? Yeah, I think, I hate to burst your bubble, chat, but I think she actually finished that piece.
Yeah.
Before the show started, and then we just switched over to the completed piece.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm kidding. No, I did do it on the show kind of a little bit.
Sort of.
One day. One day, chat. One day. I promise.
Nesquet. I like that. I like it.
Nesquet. Oh, yeah. I like that too. It's a good name.
That's also like Nesquik.
Nesquik. Oh, God. Now I'm thirsty.
Yep.
God, this show is making
me hungry
and
thirsty. Yeah, we're not allowed to talk about food or drink.
Yeah. Could you guys stop, please?
Yeah. Calm down, chat.
Calm down.
All right. So let's check out this next piece. I love that the guns are toys, but the cigar or cigarette that is in his mouth
is most
completely
real. Super real.
Or at least that's what I assume. I do like what you did with his hair. It kind of, I like, it's got that whole like front on pompadour thing going on that Apollo rocks.
Yeah, it's true. I like that he's dressed like an elf. That was so cute. Oh my
God. It's the holidays, right?
I woke up like this.
Oh God.
I'm sorry. It's just so fun to say. To sing.
And we have a piece by Sarah Rutter. Hooray.
Oh, my God. No. This is exciting, though, because Sarah's always giving us, like, don't get me wrong, Sarah, we love your artwork and your style is great, but you always give us the same kind of style or the same kind of format where it's just the god busts, and we love it. Don't get us wrong, but we love that you gave us something.
Love seeing some change.
Yeah, you gave us something new. You gave
us Fenrir. That goes for everyone. We love seeing some new stuff by everyone.
Yeah, we always like to see you guys grow during the art show and show us what you can do, and this is great.
Oh, it's a candy cane. Oh, well, I'm just the bad one. Damn.
What?
In Apollo's mouth. It was a candy cane, not a cigar.
Idiot.
Wow, I'm just so bad at this.
You idiot.
But this is adorable. I love that Fenrir's nose is like, he's got the red nose held on top.
Cute.
That's really cute.
Good job.
I want you to say this name.
It's actually Spartosaurus Rex.
Well, that's not nearly as much fun.
Yeah, well, you just spelled it wrong.
Well.
It's Spartosaurus Rex,
that's
Gavin.
That's on me, I guess.
You got egg on your face. You got eggnog on your face.
But
it's the holidays.
I do love this. A little Mario. they
really
had the eyebrows, too. Itty bitty mustache.
Oh, it's adorable.
It's like the tiniest of mustaches.
The teensiest of mustaches.
It works really well, honestly.
It does.
Like, it looks like there was very little photo manipulation needed to make these two things work together.
Honestly, I would play Cupid if
with a
like
Super
this.
Mario skin.
Yeah, because I don't like Cupid. I'm not a fan.
I like his voice. It's pretty funny.
Yeah. Moving on.
Unusual Pie. We have Handsome Evo. Man. Super handsome.
Oh my God, this guy's is taken from a very popular image from the internets of Squidward from SpongeBob SquarePants fame. When he got super handsome. So they did this for Hebo, and I must say, I'm catching feels.
I think the best Hebo drawing ever really encapsulates it, really.
Yeah, I'm catching something. Oh, it is very hot in here.
He looks like he's just handsome.
So handsome.
Fully handsome.
I can't handle it. I can't. It's so good. Oh my God, these feathers.
So we have a Kako Demon Ymir here by Victor Kolodin.
This
I love
great.
This. Is this pen? Yeah, I think it is.
We don't get a lot of this particular skin on the show.
It's a mean-looking skin,
art.
Too.
It is. I remember like thinking that when it was
it's
really
a mean-looking
like,
drawing. He's just like...
It's scary.
Yep.
It's so scary. Excellent job. And traditional. We've gotten a lot of traditional pieces this show.
He's not only looks demonic in that, but also completely insane.
Yeah.
So, hooray.
We should.
So let's check out this next piece by... No, I'm not, guys, I'm not even, I'm going to whisper it this time.
All right.
Whoa, what? Wiggly Willy Wolf! Get
blah,
on.
Blah, blah,
get
blah.
Get on.
We're so sorry.
No, I'm not.
Okay, Gavin's not, but I am. I'm very sorry for him.
We got this Wiggly Willy Wolf up in here. We got Ra ulting a minion's face.
I just love the
This is
Ra's
dead on.
Face.
I actually think we should talk with Willy because you're not allowed to submit just screenshots without altering them.
Yeah, this is exactly. Dude, listen. This is against the rules. This is an exact screenshot.
Yeah. Like,
what is wrong
with you? I see
you
took out the background with your violet color, but this is just in-game. Come on, man.
In-game footage. It's ridiculous. Thank you, Wiley. You're the best. This next one is by Yusuf Driz Shabi. Shabi? Shabai? Shabich?
Okay, no.
I can't stop. But it's my boy Anubis.
Mean looking Anubis.
Yes, this is actually taken from his card art that you can see on the Smite landing page.
It looks like he's about to, Plague of Locust, real hard.
Yeah,
like,
super hard. I love him so much, guys. Oh my god, I love Anubis. And this is great. And very well shaded, too. Like his cheekbones and everything like that. That is insanely shaded.
He looks like a jackal that's also mostly undead.
Yeah.
Yeah, it gets across his whole, Anubis' whole theme really, really well.
Very well done. Thank you so much, Yusuf. And I'm so sorry for butchering your name.
So that brings us to the discussion pieces.
Oh, my God.
So every week we have 15 pieces that we pick.
Yep.
I just did, a lot of hand motions to signify 15, but I think I actually got to 30 when I did that. So.
Yeah, did you?
Oops. But there is a little lightning bolt by the top picks, and the people who win top pick get 600 plus gems.
What?
The plus part is for people who...
Who what?
Do the challenge.
You get do a challenge.
200 extra challenge.
Oh, yeah.
If you win top pick.
Yeah, guys, so we got to motivate you to do the challenge because it's the holiday season.
Got to get you some extra gems, right? There's going to be tons of cool skins coming out. Got the Odyssey rocking right now. You want them gems.
Oh, my
but
God.
Let's go on to Alex Xiao. This is originally animated. Oh, there we go.
Yay, it worked. It's super big, but there it is. It's Zonkui.
All about that. We have an animated pixel sprite for Zonkui, and he's looking mean.
He is looking
so
mean.
So we really do need to get that 2D version of Smite rolling.
Yeah.
I know Chiwa got on it. And did a really good job.
Mm-hmm. This is great, though.
This is wonderful. He looks like he could be a boss.
Yeah. Oh, my God. That would be so fun. I really think that there should be a Smite
role-playing
2D.
Game. Yeah, that would be so good. But, look at the shading, it works. I think his chest hair is moving. I don't know if those dots are supposed to be his chest hair, but I'm just going to say it is. His brush flops back and forth. The only thing it's missing is his little scroll.
Oh, yeah, that's the only
thing. But that's it. Everything else is amazing.
Yeah, everything else is on point.
Yep.
Oh, man, I love that.
So let's check out this next piece by Ada Garrett.
Yes, 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 please.
We have some more Nox love.
Get that Nox love. Wait, what? Sorry, something with my drawing. I was, trying to figure it out. I love this. I love how black the lines are. You guys, obviously, with my style, you know, I love thick
black
lines. Oop, what? Okay. Production.
No big deal, everyone. everything is as as it's meant to be.
Yeah.
But I really like this. Like, we've got a lot of her powers coming off her hands. You got the shading. There's a lot of dark colors, yet you did a really solid, her skin. You've got this kind of, pale, fair-looking skin.
I just like it. It's very well done, how even her hair or those long trails behind her are all outlined, and you utilize the brushes really well. You have obviously a soft round brush for the little bulbs on her dress, and then you still have all your brushes, your other brush strokes on the skin, even on her hair, on her helmet, very well defined. I think you use a hard round brush for that. I love that. I love it when you guys can utilize different brushes and make it into one really cool piece. So,
and I don't know why she's holding her other glove. But I guess
she
was just like, you
know
what?
Somebody.
It's time to throw down. And she just you want? Hold my gloves.
No, she did the old fashioned, I challenge you to a duel, sir.
Yeah, just slapped him.
Oh, man. All right.
Well, this is just a wonderful piece.
She's a classy lady, all right?
And let's move on to this piece by Elena Pina.
Pina.
This is Kokolkin in mega god form. Look at that.
Good God.
Being worshipped.
Somebody let him near the protein.
Yeah, he's getting big.
He is buff.
Or eating one of those super mushrooms from Mario.
My anaconda. Kevin, why? No, I love this.
I'm so sorry.
Guys, I'm just hyper because I'm so excited to be here. I'm so happy. I love this, though. I love the scale, the sheer scale of Kukulkan here. And then you used the smudge tool on the clouds. And I really like the pyramid that you used, the Mayan pyramid down there.
Yep.
Really good job. Excellent job on it.
It looks like they sacrificed someone. Because there's like two people who have their hands up in the air, and there's one person just laying there.
Yeah,
so
just chilling.
Looks like that person.
That person ate it.
Not chilling, but dead.
No.
Sacrificed.
Super.
And they're like, look at us, Kukulkan, we did it. And he's just like,
no,
storms.
Fools.
Eat storms.
You're wrong. That's not
I've
how
got,
you do things.
I've got all of the storms right now.
But yeah, good job, Elena. A nice name, too. That's my mom's name. Oh, this one's gorgeous. This is by Laura Bossman, and it's Kronos.
Very highly stylized Kronos.
Yep.
I love it. He's just chilling. He's like, I'm just going to put my scythe here. I'm just going to
just hang out. Excuse
like,
me
up
real quick.
Against this.
Can I just come here? Right? Thank you.
He's like, yo, what's up? You want your soul harvested?
It's nice to see Thanatos so relaxed, usually, in all of his poses, because he's such a daunting character to draw, I imagine.
I mean,
like,
he's never like he's tense, but he's just always kind of like this,
he's ready to go.
This figure that's just like, I'm going to just, your soul, taking it.
Yeah, he's just ready to fight all the time. So it's really nice to see him pose in a different way. Very chill. Very calm. I don't trust it. But I like the style too. Lineless, just the colors. And it's nice because you don't, be without lines, you would think that, oh, well, the drawing gets lost in it. But no, you can tell exactly what's going on.
Yeah.
Excellent job.
The flame effects look really great as well. It's just it's a good piece.
Yeah, it's a good piece.
Move on to, oh, my God.
All right. Michael Dean Lang actually tweeted at us a couple times on Twitter. And, guys, for some of you that are new, you can tweet at us. You can follow us at Smite Art Show. You can follow our own respective Twitters, but we'll do that later. But he tweeted these pictures at us, and he was asking, like, which one's better, and he got a general consensus from us and from the community. So it's also really good to do that, guys. If you have a Twitter, it's totally fine to do that. But my personal favorite regarding the piece, I love the one that doesn't have the effect on Ao Kuang.
The traditional old owl.
I actually really like being able to see him. The effect on the other one, I don't know. I'm not a big fan of it. I really just prefer.
I think they're trying to take that whole like the cyberpunk Naja.
Yeah.
And give it like he's fighting a hologram Ao Kuang.
Yeah. So trying to make it relevant to the skin. And I get that, but I don't know. I just really like to see all the hard work that you put into Ao Kuang, because as you can see, it's lineless. All it is, it reminds me of those paint by numbers paintings. You remember those?
Yeah.
It looks like that. Every single different color tone.
The colors are very distinct. Yeah.
It's like one on top of the other. So this is fantastic. I really like it. I like both of them, but my preference is the one where Ao Kuang isn't digital. So good job, and this is obviously a top pick. Because of that, because it's awesome. This next one is by Michael Farashiewicz.
This is my favorite part of the whole show.
Farashiewicz. Production with the zinger. This is Ho 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 Neath.
Emma's like falling apart over here. Get it together, woman. Like.
Oh, I love production.
But
so
we
much.
Have a holiday skin for Neath. It looks like she's still wearing her like standard outfit underneath.
Yeah, they just
like,
went.
Oh, it's a little cold outside. Let me suit up, and then she just puts on some extra stockings, and they're like,
let me just do what I want.
That doesn't
this.
Make you any warmer. What are you what are you doing? She's like, you know, I gotta look good still, right?
Listen, I gotta look super good.
I gotta rep that Egypt mostly naked thing.
I do like the pose, though. The pose is incredibly well done. It's a very, well, not very difficult, but it's a tough pose to do. The angle up, you know. It's good, though. I like the pyramid covered in snow. That's good, too. So, excellent job. Next.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, this piece, guys. This is by Oni S. Len Yen. And it's a top pick, obviously.
Yeah.
We don't get too much Aries, but when we do, it's
holy
amazing.
Crap. Yeah. He looks fierce. The only thing I'd say is that his sword looks a little on the Mayan side.
Oh, yeah, I can see that. Mm-hmm.
It's got those harsh angles that the we often use for our Mayan characters. But other than that, like, oh, my goodness.
Good.
I like that he's got his like chains wrapping around the sword. He just looks... He looks... Fierce.
He's got chains times
terrifying.
Two. There's so many chains on him right now.
He's
horrifying. But just excellent use of everything, like all the space here. It's got such fluidity to it, and the ripped cape, excellent. The details are insane. There's chains everywhere. It's amazing. It gets you a little confused, like what was your medium that you used, because there's so much texture to it as well. Like, it looks like it might be a painting, or it might be Photoshop. Either way, super impressive.
The glow effects from the fire onto the gold and metal of the sword and his helmet. Oh man.
Yeah.
I'm all about that.
Are you?
That's so good.
Yeah, it's really well done.
Plus, he's got like lats and abs for days.
Yeah, that's just my favorite part. Hey, what's your name? What's your number?
I think it's Aries, actually.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
And I think he existed before phone numbers were a thing. So,
darn.
Sorry about that. Yeah, sorry.
Well, then, moving on to the next one.
So, this is by Raven Hackberry. And this is a very different style than what we usually get from Raven, who you probably recognize the name from one of our chat moderators.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe this is from Stencils. I think homemade stencils and spray paint. I think Raven was saying, tweeted at us that this is the first time playing around in that medium. And
yeah.
Wow. It looks great, honestly.
It's insane, dude. I love this. And it's not just because it's Anubis. It's just the fact that you did something new with it. We want to see that, guys. Get ballsy with your drawings and with your techniques. And this is a perfect example of that. This is so good. Good God. It's like one of those street... You know how some street performers do spray paint art?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's what it reminds me of. You did such an excellent job, Raven, and we can't wait to see more from you using this specific medium. So good.
Yeah, definitely play around more with it, because I'd love to see what you're capable of doing. Which is why we gave it top pick. It's
exactly.
Just like, you know.
It deserves it, for sure, 100%.
Yep.
Good God, so good. And the color scheme, too. This one, guys, this is gorgeous. This is by Steven Arguello, and it's Scylla, taken from the lore, actually. The bottom picture of Scylla, and he did it in a stained glass fashion, which, if you guys don't remember the first Freya lore piece that we did, we actually wanted it in that fashion.
All,
we
yeah,
wanted it
all in, that style. Yeah,
we wanted it in stained glass, so this is fantastic. It's a nice little reminiscing done for us. Reminiscing.
I love that they have all the things they used for this right there. Like,
yeah.
And not evenly, like, cleanly distributed. It's just like, I'm finished, take the picture. Boom.
There you go.
It's done. But yeah, I love the watercolors. Everything looks really nice. The colors. Scylla looks even more terrifying than normal.
Yeah.
Which is always impressive.
That's beautiful. It actually looks like it is a stained glass piece.
Yeah.
I would love to know what kind of paper you used for. You might have used like Bristol or something like that, but it's gorgeous. I would imagine it'd be really cool if you used like somewhat of a thin paper. You can put this, tape it on a window.
Oh yeah, light
and might
behind
give it,
it
that
would
effect.
Be so good.
Yeah, it might give it that effect.
Good call, Kayla.
Yeah, right.
All right, guys, that's pretty much it for all of our fan art for this week. Like we said, we don't have
that
much.
Yeah, it's a bit
short. But we should check out what Enna's doing for the last
guys,
few,
I'm so close.
Few minutes, because she might actually
do
this.
I am so close. I'm just doing like a very basic shading here, guys, where I set a layer to multiply, and I take
so
a color.
So is that what you're doing for the color? Because like, I know I've always had problems picking the color that I should be using for shading.
Yeah.
So can you just... briefly
well,
give me some insight so I can improve my shading.
I will, Gavin. So yeah. If you set it to multiply, what's really good to do is take a color that is very similar to the base color. So, what's it called? The little jaguar friend is brown. So I took a very light brown, very, very light, because obviously with multiply it makes anything darker. It doesn't matter how light it is. It's
right.
Going to make it darker. So I just took... a light brown, and now I'm doing these brush strokes that it almost mimics the fur on her. You don't want to make it like just a straight line, because that it looks
right.
smooth. So you want to give it the appearance
give
of fur.
Give that some depth.
Yeah.
Depth.
And this is actually like the laziest form of coloring, guys, for me. So I just really want to finish it. So.
Well, it's working because you're using you're doing a panther, which is mostly fur. So using those those like sharp, or not sharp, but like feathered.
Yeah.
Shading really adds a lot to the... looks more like hair.
Yeah. And this is my favorite part here, is doing these kind of brush strokes to kind of accent the muscular.
Yeah, yeah.
Head of jaguar. Of head.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So. Love it. Wee. Oh my god.
She's so close, everyone.
Oh my god, guys, I'm so close. Please. Please don't leave me.
But while we're looking at Anna desperately try to finish her first piece in the art show, let's talk a little bit about where you can find us and where you can submit art. Because don't forget, you can always, if you go to the info section, if you look like right down there in the info section, if you scroll down, you'll see a Hades classic skin that is done by Kayla. And you can click that, and that will take you to the submission form, and you could submit your art there. Please be sure to do that. We love seeing what you got, and we'll go through it next week so we can, show what you got.
So we can do what?
Show it off.
So we can, yeah?
We can show off your stuff.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, and if I do actually end up finishing this, I will be posting it on Twitter immediately and boasting about it. So ardently. So there's that. And also, if you notice, guys, just a quick little tip too. Like I said, with use a color that you can use a color that goes with the base color, just a lighter version. But when you have an instant where you have a character that's got a lot of colors, like Owlix here, it's good to use a neutral color. Just one solid color instead of having to change each multiply layer to the color of whatever you're drawing. So I just used a blue, a very light blue, and see it even like translates well to different colors. So you don't have to like worry your heads about it. Whee!
Not one bit.
Not one little bit.
So guys, don't forget to follow us on at Smite Fan Art or Smite.
Where?
Just, you know.
Don't forget to follow us at Smite Art Show.
Thank you.
And Twitter. You can find us also. I'm HiRez Enna or at Enna Miranda Buns. He's HiRez Gavin.
HiRez Gavin.
And you can find us there. You
and
can
send us,
tweet at
send
us.
Send us your arts because we will talk about it
and
give you responses and favorite and retweet the stuff that we really love.
And we will give you as much help as we can, as many suggestions as we can for your work in progresses or anything like that. So do not be afraid to do that. So hold on. So close.
Are we just stalling the show just so you can finish this now?
A little bit, yeah.
All right, guys.
No, I'm kidding. Everyone's going to hate me. That's the main thing. If it were to be
let's
finished.
Let's go full. Yeah.
There it is.
Look at that.
Come on, I'm going to do a messy one. Bam. Quick. Just nice and quick.
Nice and quick.
Nice and quick. Doop, 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 boobies.
Yeah, don't forget to shade her personality.
I can't forget that. Not her personality. And this hand from heaven. It's so good.
Guys,
so
it looks like we've done it. What do you think? What do you think,
hold
chat?
Hold on. Almost. Wait.
Oh, my God.
Okay, wait.
Okay. Anyways, see you all next week.
Got it.
Oh, my goodness. See you all next week. Same time. Nope. And a half hour earlier next week.
Oh, yeah? Again?
But same place, definitely. So
we'll be here.
See you all.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Thanks for joining us.